Matoto.
Nina Panda Cuckoo.
Nina Panda Toto.
Nina Panda Cuckoo.
Cold world. Southside, can't get enough, can't get enough. East side, west side, worldwide.
So I got back from Air Force field training a couple days ago, and I was trying to brainstorm some video ideas because I have a couple days free before I head back to campus. And I was kind of reflecting on the summer, and I came up with this idea, and I think it should be a pretty good video, so stick around. All right, what's up guys? It's Josh. We're back in with another video. Like I said, today's video is going to be a little bit different because I'm going to be talking about a topic I've never really talked about on this channel, and that is kind of language learning and how that kind of ties in with my experience this summer. I spent 2 months this summer in Tanzania and Kenya on an Air Force language program. So it's this program called Project Go Global Officer, where they can send Air Force RGC cadets on trips to learn critical language skills. In this case, I was learning the Swahili language, which is the language that's spoken in most of East Africa. So I was there for over 60 days and we had Swahili class almost every single day. The only days that we didn't have Swahili class were the days that we were traveling, and even then we were trying to have conversations with our teachers while we were in the van or the bus or wherever we were. A lot of times, like for the first couple weeks, class was literally like 4 hours a day of Swahili. And then gradually it kind of got less and less as we got more busy and began traveling more throughout the program. Our teachers were actually pretty cool because for the first half of the program, our teacher was actually a native Kenyan from Nairobi. And then as we got into the second, so the first half of the program was in Tanzania, and then as we moved into Kenya, we actually picked up two more Swahili tutors who were also Kenyan, and they were great as well, provided more extra conversation practice. To kind of preface this video, I knew absolutely no Swahili going into this program, like literally nothing. Before the program, they sent me a little sheet of like stuff that I should study before I get there, because we did have a quiz on the first day, but it was super basic stuff. It was like, Habari za leo, or Jina langu ni Josh, you know, like your basic like day one stuff that you need to know. And it picked up pretty quick. So before the summer started, I kind of thought of it as kind of a challenge. It was kind of cool to start fresh on a brand new language that I had never studied before, because French, after studying it for like 7 years, kind of just really dragged on, and it was kind of cool just to completely start something fresh. So I kind of wanted to track my progress and see how much I could learn in the 2 months that I was there when I started from absolutely zero. So obviously before I left, I did use a little bit of like Duolingo and other apps, but Duolingo really isn't great for Swahili, to be honest. A lot of the translations don't match up because Swahili doesn't have like a lot of the articles and other words that English has. So a lot of times you get incorrect translations, which was kind of frustrating. But I also just used the giant package that they sent us to learn. And because Swahili really, like, Google Translate is not very effective at all for Swahili when it comes to like getting the words that you need. So you really just need a Swahili dictionary or like a book that explains it really well. So I'll kind of give a little comparison between Swahili and the other language that I know, French. So French and a lot of the Romance languages, kind of one of the hardest parts of the language is the different tenses and the irregularities between these tenses. Like French alone, like just the past tense is a very complex tense because it's two parts, and some verbs, if you want to say them in the past tense, take a certain verb and some take another, and with those different verbs, some of the past participles are irregular as well. And all these different tenses are conjugated in different ways, and although most of the tense constructions are very mechanical, there's a lot of irregularities. Whereas on the Swahili side, I literally learned the past, the present, the future, and the conditional tense all within the first week, because they're very simple to construct and there's barely any irregularities except when it comes to like monosyllabic verbs. The hardest part about Swahili, which is actually the easiest part about most of the other languages I'm familiar with, is nouns. Like, you learn a noun in French and that's the way it is. Like, it may have a masculine or a feminine form, and that kind of changes the way that the adjectives are, but in reality it's pretty simple. Whereas Swahili has noun classes, whereas like French would just have masculine or feminine, Swahili has like 9 different noun classes, which completely changes the way that the grammar is constructed for these different nouns. So like your demonstrative pronouns, your possessive pronouns, the connectives, like all these different things change depending on which noun class you're in. And some of the noun classes are pretty self-explanatory, like the imwa class is people, animals, and insects. So it's pretty easy to determine that it's in that noun class. But then you have the other noun classes like GMA or like in class, which literally is just random verbs. You kind of have to, when you learn a new verb, you have to memorize which noun class it goes into, in addition to learning all the grammar for every single noun class. So that's kind of the hardest part for Swahili, I would say. So I've come pretty far in learning the language in only 2 months. Like I said, I really wanted to dedicate my summer to learning this language and kind of see how far I could grow starting from absolutely zero. And I made a lot of really good progress. At the end of the summer, as part of the Project Go program, you have to take something called an OPI, which is basically it's a phone call and it's a verbal Swahili assessment that's ran through the Air Force and the Department of Defense to kind of see how far you've grown in the language and kind of give you an assessment. So they kind of grade you on a scale from like 0, 1, 1 plus, 2, 2 plus, 3. 3 would be considered like a pretty advanced speaker, someone who's not like natively fluent, but somebody that's good enough to speak the language and talk about some complex topics, whereas 1 is just like your basic stuff and 2 is somewhere in between. I actually ended up scoring a 2 on the exam after only 2 months of Swahili prep, so I was able to talk about some more complex issues like the politics and the economies of Tanzania and Kenya and the different problems that these countries face in Swahili, which was pretty cool. So to kind of demonstrate a little bit of how much I've learned, I'm actually going to attempt to talk about myself for a minute or two in Swahili. I'll probably put subtitles at the bottom so you guys can actually understand what I'm saying. Just to kind of demonstrate how much I've actually learned this summer, because it's honestly wild. So let me begin. Hujambo, jina langu ni Josh, nina miaka ishirini, sasa nina enda chuo kikuu cha Yale, mbapo nina soma sayansi ya kompyuta na uhandisi wa umeme. Lakini wakati wa msimu wa kiangazi nilisoma Kiswahili katika shule ya Afrika Mashariki kwa jeshi ya anga ya Marekani. Nimesoma Kiswahili kwa miezi miwili na nimesafiri karibu na nchi za Tanzania na Kenya. Nilijifunza vitu vingi katika Afrika Mashariki na niliweza kufanya mazoezi Kiswahili changu na watu wa Afrika Mashariki. Kwa mfano, nilikaa na familia katika chuo kikuu cha Dar es Salaam na katika mji wa Chavakali katika Kenya na watu wa Luo na mji wa Lenkisem na watu wa Masai. Niliposafiri katika Afrika Mashariki, nilitembelea kisiwa cha Zanzibar ambapo nilinunua vitu vingi kama machora au nguo kama hii. Pia nilitembelea Serengeti ambapo niliona wanyama wengi kama simba na twiga na punda malia. Sasa ninafikiri Kiswahili changu ni kizuri. Ninafikiri, lakini ninataka kuendelea kujifunza Kiswahili katika chuo kikuu changu mwaka huu. Asante kwa kusikiliza na tutuonana baadaye. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that. It's a little weird for me to speak a foreign language on camera. I did a little bit of French stuff last year, but that was kind of fun, and I feel like I've progressed a lot. I don't know if there's any Swahili speakers that are viewers of mine. Feel free to drop some Swahili down below and let me know how I did, but that's the progress I made after 2 months, and I was able to just kind of free flow to talk about myself. That was just off the top of my head. I hope that was good. Overall, the experience in East Africa and learning Swahili was incredible, and I was very surprised by just how in-depth and how much this program really changed my views on things and allowed me to connect with people all the way across the world. And I never thought that, I don't know, I kind of wrote the program off. I didn't know how good like an ROTC language program was gonna be, because I'd already done like a Yale study abroad program, but sorry Yale, but this program was miles beyond anything I had in Paris last summer, and it was completely funded by the Department of Defense and the military. So it's great opportunities for anyone that's that's an ROTC cadet that wants to wants to study a critical language, especially because I started from scratch. Like, they actually let me join the program when I knew no Swahili, and half the people there didn't know any Swahili. Like, it was about half and half newbies and returners. So as I said in my little Swahili blurb, I do think I want to continue studying Swahili. I'm not sure how my schedule is going to work out at Yale this semester yet, but I really kind of fell in love with the language. And since it's a critical language and it actually will serve me well in my future career in the Air Force, I think I do want to continue studying it. I feel like there's a lot of benefits to doing so over like French. Honestly, like after my study abroad in French, I didn't want to take any more French, whereas Swahili came back and I'm really pumped and excited, and I kind of want to keep taking it, which I guess is a good sign. So that's about it for this video. Hope you guys enjoyed me telling my story about how I tried to learn Swahili in 2 months, and I think I did a pretty good job. Let me know what you guys thought of this video down below. I know it's kind of strange and not a normal type of video that I would do, but let me know what you thought in the comments down below. If you're excited that I'm back and pumping out more content, drop a like, because that helps me and supports the channel a lot more than you think. If anyone's new and somehow found this video because Swahili was in the title or language learning or something along that, feel free to subscribe. I post a lot of different stuff on this channel, and this is just one little aspect of my life. So with that, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and see you next time.